Hello everyone, today I'm a little bit disappointed by my experience with Tesla service department, customer service, and I wanted to share with you guys my experience. The topic is the range. Everything starts from here, as you can see from my app. The maximum amount of charge that I can get now out of my Tesla Model 3 long range is 276 miles of range for a full charge at 100%. Now, as you all know, when the Tesla Model 3 long range came with 310 miles of range. Actually, when I purchased it, a new update was released that allowed the car to have 320 miles of range. But for now, let's consider the stated range when I purchased the car, that was 310 miles. Now, with that being said, I wanted to go ahead with a short premise, and then I will show you the feedback that I got from Tesla, and I would love to have your feedback to that regard. Now, based on my understanding, the miles that is the range that is stated here is, let's call it a theoretical range. That range doesn't change. It is just based on two factors that are the capacity of the battery. Let's consider 75,000 watt. Divided times 310 miles, that gives us 242 watt per mile of energy consumption. That means that if we use the car and we consume 242 watt per mile, we get 310 miles. In this case, we get 199 miles of range. However, the drive style, so the speed, the whether we use AC or whether we use the heated seat or sentry mode and so on, those kind of variables can affect the projected range. Now, as you can see, my stated range, theoretical range, and the projected range is different only by a few miles, not 40 miles. And that is due to the fact that I have been, since last charge, consumed in average 320 watt per mile. And we know that only by, if we consume 242 watt per mile, as we computed here, we are able to have a projected range equal to the stated range. Now, where I want to arrive with this video is to say, well, this range, which is what I showed you guys by looking at the app, should be still 310 miles. So for a full charge of my Tesla, I should still get 310 miles worth of theoretical range. And that theoretical range means I can get 310 miles only if I drive consuming 242 watt per mile. Now, this range changed in less than 2 years, and my car has only 2,000 miles. It changed from 310 to 275, which means that my battery now can only store, let me compute it for you guys, can only store 75,000 watt, which is the capacity of my battery, divided times 275 miles. Sorry, let me compute it again. 75 miles, that is what I can get from my car. So now, if I do 275,000 miles, 75, holy moly, we have only 275. So if we do 275 miles of range that I can get at 100% of charge times 242, I get 66,000-ish. Sorry, I needed some time to do this computation, but the idea is that the stated range when I got my car was 310 miles. If you divided it times, if we take 75,000 watt full capacity of my battery, and we divide it times 242 watt per mile, I get my 310 miles. So the idea is that this theoretical range is computed by using a standard energy consumption, which is 242 watt per mile, according to my understanding. And that doesn't change. So if now my car can only get 275 miles rather than 310 at the same consumption of 242, that means that my battery is only storing 66 kilowatt rather than 75. How I drive my car shouldn't affect the stated rate. The speed, the sentry mode, heated seat, AC should only affect the projected one, according to my understanding. So now I want to show you guys the feedback that I got from Tesla. And here is my phone. So my request was, why my range decreased from 310 to 275? And I was referring to the stated range, not to the projected one. The projected one changes every time based on how I drive and a lot of other factors. But the stated range should be the same, because computed as a total kilowatt of capacity of the battery divided times a theoretical consumption, which should be 242. So with that being said, that was the reply from Tesla. If there are no alerts, then nothing is wrong. The battery management is learning your driving style and is giving you the number it thinks you are going to get out of that charge, not the potential. Everything comes into play when it comes to range, air conditioning, heater, accessories, and so on. It calculates all of that from past drive cycles and tries to give you the number it thinks you will get, not of what it is capable. The battery management is second to none, no one, and if there are no alerts, then nothing needs to be fixed. Now, they are trying to tell me that based how I drive, that the Tesla tells me the full range. But again, when I full charge my battery, now I get 275 here. And this number is not the projected, which is affected by the fact that since last charge, I use 320 watt per mile, which means more than the 242 we were talking about. So higher consumption, lower projected range. This is a stated one and should always be the same. If that decreases, that means that my battery is storing less, or the battery needs to be calibrated. And then my reply was, 310 miles is the range that I should get for a full charge. Potential range, computed as 75,000 watt, the capacity of the battery, at 242 watt per mile of energy consumption. Now, my battery can only get 275 miles of range, of potential range. This means that I can only store approximately 66 kilowatt out of 75. Air conditioning, speed, and other conditions affects the projected range that is displayed in the energy monitoring section. At 100% charge, the projected range is 230 miles, which is an estimate based on the speed and other factors. With that being said, the question is the same. Why am I able only to store roughly 66 kilowatt hour in the battery? And here I said that I drive with my family to a beach house, and I used to do that last year in the same period with the same condition in one full charge at the same speed. Now I need to stop every time 5 to 7 minutes to charge my car. So it clearly means that my car no longer stores that amount of charge. And the reply was here. A majority of range loss on your vehicle is from sentry mode and user interaction when the vehicle is idle. We also see range loss from driving over 65 miles per hour, a high HVAC usage. Turn off sentry mode, keeping your speed below 65, limiting your HVAC use should help you raise your projected range. They are referring to the projected range, which is affected by that. But my question is, why my stated range decreased in less than 2 years, and my car has only 22,000 miles from 310 miles to 275. And they closed my service. The service appointment has been closed. For additional service needs, schedule an appointment with view the app. So they pretty much didn't even allow me to keep reply to that feedback. They close the conversation saying, if you want, open another appointment. Now, guys, I can be wrong. I wanted to share with all of you my understanding, and I wanted to have your feedback. I would like to know what you think about that, if you're experiencing the same issue. I leased my Tesla. I'm about to return my car. I wanted to get another Tesla, but I'm very concerned about all these things. It's really unjustifiable that from 310 miles worth of range, now I'm only getting 275 miles. Because we need to consider that if I can bring a stupid example, let's consider a traditional car. Let's consider that car has a tank for gas with a capacity of 10 gallon. And with 10 gallon, that car can drive for 100 miles, let's say. Now, if that car suddenly, the tank decreases from 10 gallons, now can only store 8 gallons, right? Now, what I want to understand is if in our example, the capacity of the battery on its own decreased, so that means that physically my battery can no longer store 75 kilowatt but only 66, and that would justify the decrease from 310 miles to 275, because that decrease needs to be also considered on top of the habit, the driving habit. So how fast I drive, how much I use my HVAC, how much I use the heated seats, because that projected range is on top of my stated range. So if I lost already 35 miles because my battery can no longer store them, it's a problem. And I cannot fix that by driving at 20, 25 miles per hour. It's over. Sorry guys for the long video. I don't like to upload long videos. This time, this was a very important topic. I wanted to share with you all. I wanted to have your feedback. Sorry for the terrible edit of this video, for having to do 5 times my computation of the consumption. It has been a very long day at work, and my brain, I think, is a little bit burnt. But please let me know what you think, and thank you all.